Hello, Mother Factors. Sam here for 101 Facts About Orange Is the New Black. But I'm not on my own. As you can see, I'm joined by Brogan and Libby from their new exciting channel, Bloom. Now, guys, what is Bloom all about?
Well, Sam, we draw,
we drink tea,
and we ask the important questions.
I mean, a myriad of topics with some beautiful illustrations, really digging deep down into those subjects.
Yeah, of course.
I'm loving what you're doing so far. Thank you for helping me out in this video, but in order to pay them thanks, please subscribe to Bloom right now. I'll give you a couple of seconds to do so. All right, they should be back now. So, without further ado, this is 101 Facts About Orange
Is the New
Black. Go.
Number one. Just in case you thought this video is some fashion advice for you, it ain't, though I'm definitely the guy to go to. I mean, look at this t-shirt. Nay, this is about the internet-based television show Orange Is the New Black, which debuted on Netflix on the 11th of July 2013 and was created by Jenji Kohan. Number two. Jenji Kohan has had some experience in writing LOLs before, in fact, even before they were referred to as LOLs. Way before she created Orange Is the New Black, she wrote an episode of the 90s classic The Fresh Prince of Bel-Air, entitled Stop Will, In the Name of Love. Bit of a weird title, that one, but I'm sure the episode was great. Number three. She also produced more LOLs and maybe even the odd Ruffle later, when she wrote for Mad About You, Sex in the City, Gilmore Girls, and Will and Grace. Number four. Orange Is the New Black, or Oitnb, or OITNB, has 68 episodes across four seasons. The fifth season will be released on bail, see what I did there, in June of 2017. Number five. This is five, by the way, out of seven seasons that have been approved for the show, concluding in 2019. Number six. Orange Is the New Black was one of the very first Netflix exclusive series to ever hit the bloody website, and is now actually the most watched Netflix original series on the whole bloody website. Sorry, I don't know why I keep saying bloody website. That's even more than House of Cards, which we did a video on last week, by the way, or Daredevil. Number seven. In fact, its fourth season was streamed over 23 million times during its first 35 days of release.
Number eight. The series is based on Piper Kerman's real-life book, Orange Is the New Black, My Year in a Woman's Prison, which is, somewhat unsurprisingly, about the real-life experiences she had while in prison, presumably while wearing orange.
Number 9. The title Orange Is the New Black originated from a saying from the fashion industry. Just in case you don't know, it used to mean that a new colour has become fashionable, just as black once was.
Check me out, being all hip and swanky.
Number 10. In case you were wondering, by the way, Kerman was sentenced to 15 months in prison, but only served 13 months in the end. She was let out early, by the way. She didn't escape or anything. Number 11. The rights for the story were actually originally retained by Ryan Murphy, who is best known for being the writer and producer of Glee, American Horror Story, and Nip Tuck, before they were given to Cohen. Wow, imagine if he made that. It'd be full of blood, singing, and plastic surgery. Number 12. Jenji Kohan had to beg, and I mean beg, Piper Kerman to adapt her memoir into a television series. Kerman was impressed with how much Kohan wanted to tell her story authentically and so gave her the green light to make it. Number 13. There are some parts of Piper's stories that are dramatised for entertainment in the TV show. For instance, she never busted out anybody's teeth, in fact she was barely ever violent at all, and she was never sent to solitary confinement. Well done her, well behaved. Number 14. In fact, real-life Piper picked a peck of pickled pepper. Oh no, sorry, that's not what I mean. I mean, saw what effect solitary isolation had on prisoners and publicly speaks out against prisoner abuse and prisoners' rights. It's a little bit more serious than picking a peck of pickled peppers.
Number 15. Kohan knew Piper's story would appeal to network executives, but she also always planned to take the story deeper and examine the story of black women, Latino women, and older women within the show.
Number 16. In fact, for this reason, Kohan described Piper as a Trojan horse, as an in for the show to focus on characters and demographics who weren't likely to be well represented on television. Good for you, Pipes. Glad you're smuggling all those underrepresented women inside you. No, wait, that's absolutely disgusting.
Number 17. In a study based on Facebook likes of TV shows from the New York Times, it was revealed that despite the cast being very varied and having lots of diverse characters, Orange Is the New Black primarily appeals to a white audience. Number 18. Every person in the opening credits having their face put to the animal, trap, trap, trap till the cage is full, is a person who has been in prison before. They're not hired actresses. There's even a couple of shots of the real Piper Kerman herself. Tell me more about those facial expressions, Libby and Brogan.
Number 19. To get these lovely facial expressions, they were asked to visualise three things. A peaceful place, a person who makes you laugh, and lastly, something that you want to forget. You can make it a fun game next time you watch it to see if you know which is which.
Number 20. The show is set in Litchfield Penitentiary. Penitentiary? The show is set in Litchfield Penitentiary in upstate New York, but it's not real, so don't waste your time searching for it on Airbnb.
Number 21. The series itself isn't actually shot in a prison at all for fairly obvious reasons. It's actually filmed in an old children's psychiatric centre called Rockland Children's Psychiatric Centre in New York State. Shooting in an old psychiatric centre for children? Oh, man, that sounds creepy as all heck. Number 22. The real-life Piper actually served her time at the Danbury Federal Correctional Institution in Connecticut. Number 23. Danbury Federal Correctional Institution is also where Real Housewife Teresa Giudice and homemaker Martha Stewart served their time too, so Piper was clearly in great company.
Number 24. The fetching orange costumes on the show are actually real prisoner chic. They bought the prison uniforms through a real prison supplier, all the way down to the bras and underwear. The costume department adds the odd accessory to help personalise each individual character's uniforms, though.
Number 25. In order to make the show more believable, Cohen and the writing staff visited the Californian Institute for Men in Chino to get a look at a real penitentiary. Yep, that's why I've been to prison too, actually. Research, definitely. Definitely not for stealing pictures of Jennifer Lawrence from a chemist. Nope, no siree, not me. Number 26. While there, Cohen talked to a prison warden and found out about how social groups are formed in women's prisons and what made them different from a men's prison, apart from, you know, anatomically. Number 27. One of the main differences she learned was that apparently women are more communal and seek out groups when in the clink, rather than male prisoners who like to spend time alone. Number 28. It's fair to say that in the show, the guards are pretty relaxed about inmates being alone and intimate with one another. This is not how prison actually is or really was for Piper, as guards apparently very rarely even let them talk to one another while alone. Number 29. In fact, the most intimate thing inmates could do with one another was pray. And by the way, I mean actually praying. I don't mean, you know, what Alex and Piper are doing here in this chapel. No, not this. No.
Number 30. The Catchy as Hell theme song is written and performed by Regina Spektor. Regina Spektor wrote the theme song specifically for the show. She was sent over a couple of unfinished episodes, which helped her see what the characters were like so she could create a fitting theme.
Number 31. The theme song,
You've Got Time,
was nominated for a Grammy in 2014, in fact.
Number 32. Orange is the New Black was extremely well received by critics upon its first release, with its first season having a 93% approval rating on Rotten Tomatoes.
Number 33. If you think that's impressive, Samington, the second series got 98% on Rotten Tomatoes. 98! That's over four more!
Number 34. In fact, it's won a total of 41 awards and has been nominated for 140, including a Screen Actors Guild Award for Outstanding Performance by an Ensemble in a Comedy Series for 3 years in a row. Number 35. Piper Kerman herself visited the set from time to time to consult on the show. Man, imagine the pressure on Taylor Schilling to perform there. It'd be like wrestling in front of The Rock, I can only imagine.
Number 36. Taylor Schilling is the actor who plays Piper Kerman. When asked what she would smuggle into jail, Taylor said that she'd smuggle in a communication device and some shampoo in case her hair falls off. Wait, what? Where would she put them to smuggle them?
Number 37. Alex Voss doesn't actually exist in real life. A lady by the name of Catherine Walters is the real-life inspiration for Alex Voss and has claimed that the show gets a lot wrong with her and Piper's relationship.
Number 38.
For starters, her and Piper's relationship did not carry over into prison. They didn't actually see each other at all until Piper was flown to Chicago to testify in her trial. Number 39. Walters has stated she wasn't Piper's first female partner and she certainly did not seduce her, which contradicts the show's narrative quite a bit too. Number 40. Laura Prepon, best known for her part as the red-headed Donna in the sitcom That 70s Show, originally auditioned for the role of Piper but ended up playing Alex Voss instead. Number 41. Prepon's character in That 70s Show actually predicted her fate in Orange is the New Black. In one episode, Donna says,
"I could get arrested. I could go to a girl prison. This freaking rocks."
Which, of course, she does in Orange is the New Black. The meaning of life. Funnily enough, actually, Lady with a Damn Cool Surname, Abigail Savage, originally auditioned for the role of Alex Voss, but got the role of Gina Murphy instead.
Number 43. Weirdly, nobody seems to get the role they wanted on this show. Yale Stone, for instance, originally auditioned for the role of Nikki Nichols, but instead got the role of Lorna Morello.
Number 44. Little bonus for you here too, Yale Stone's Jersey accent is fake. She's actually Australian. Number 45. Another Aussie in the cast is Ruby Rose, who plays Stella. Ruby Rose apparently went from sleeping on an air mattress for a whole year with her dog to, not doing that, thanks to Orange is the New Black. Lovely stuff. Number 46. Samira Wiley, who plays Poussée, does not actually speak German at all. She worked tirelessly with a dialect coach so she would sound authentic in all her German-speaking scenes. Number 47. However, Franziska, Poussée's German girlfriend, who is played by Nina Rausch, is actually German, so she's been practicing speaking German her whole life, technically. Number 48. Mei Chang, Litchfield's resident grumpy old lady, is actually specifically mentioned in Kerman's book. While talking about prison demographics, she says there was one tiny Chinese woman in her 60s. Sounds like an apt description to me. Number 49. Laurie Tan Chin, who plays Mei Chang, actually has pink hair in real life. Snazzy.
Number 50. Former Boston University sprinter and marathoner Uzo Aduba originally auditioned for the role of track star Janae. When she didn't hear back about getting the part, she decided to quit acting and considered going back to law school instead. Number 51. However, Cohen thought she would be better off as Crazy Eyes than Janae, which some could think is an insult, but there we are, and the rest was history.
Number 52. Crazy Eyes was actually only meant to appear for the first three episodes, but everyone loved her so much they kept her as a recurring character. Number 53. The description Uzo Aduba received for Crazy Eyes was, "innocent like a child, except children aren't scary." I don't know, some of them are terrifying. Number 54. Uzo Aduba became the first actress to win two Emmys in consecutive years in different categories. She won a Primetime Emmy for Outstanding Guest Actress in a Comedy Series in 2014 and a Primetime Emmy for Outstanding Supporting Actress in a Drama Series in 2015. Number 55. Matt McGorry, who plays guard and baby daddy John Bennett, didn't actually start out life as an actor. Well, obviously he started out as a baby. But a little while after that, he used to be a competitive bodybuilder and personal trainer. Number 56. Sam Healy actor Michael Harney actually has had some prison experience before, although not necessarily the bad sort. He used to do some volunteer work at Ossining State Penitentiary when he was in college. Oh, what a good guy. Number 57. Laverne Cox plays Sophia Bassett. Laverne Cox's twin brother, musician M. Lamar, played pre-transition Sophia in the series.
Number 58. Laverne Cox actually made publishing history in 2014. She's the first openly transgender person to appear on the cover of Time magazine. About time, too. See what I did there? Man, the stuff Sam makes us read.
Number 59. George Pornstache Mendez has a fabulous moustache, it must be said. The role of Pornstache is played by Pablo Schreiber, but the role of his moustache is played by some fake hair because it ain't real. Number 60. Schreiber also played Dimitri Ravitch on Cohan's other hit show, Weeds. He's also really the brother of Sabretooth, also known as Liev Schreiber. Number 61. The names of the inmates in the show are changed from their nicknames in the memoir, maybe to preserve anonymity, although surely nicknames are anonymous anyway, but hey, never mind. For example, Red was Pop, and Tasty was Delicious. Number 62. Kate Mulgrew plays Bad Lady and sometimes Good Lady and sometimes Who the Hell Knows Lady, Red. She's previously been to space, as well as prison, as she played Captain Catherine Janeway in Star Trek Voyager.
Number 63. At least Kate Mulgrew was 3D back then. Constance Schumann, also known as Yoga Jones, was the voice of Patty Mayonnaise in the cartoon series Doug for 8 years.
Nintendo 64. Lorraine Toussaint, who plays V, Danielle Brooks, who plays Tasty, and Samira Wiley, who plays Poussée, all graduated from Juilliard School of Dance, Drama and Music. Fancy. Number 65. In fact, Brooks and Wiley only graduated a year apart, so they knew each other from around campus and in classes. Ah, it's always nice to know somebody already on the inside when you go to prison, I've heard. Number 66. Jackie Cruz, who plays Flacker on the show, apparently once made out with one of that Kardashian lot. The one that begins with a K? Yeah, Courtney. I think that's her. Good for her, I think. Number 67. When Cruz was 17, she was in a car accident. Her injuries were so severe, she had to go through brain surgery and had to relearn how to walk, talk, and smile. Sheesh. Well, she's smashing it now, isn't she? You go, Jackie Cruz. Number 68. Beth Fowler plays Sister Jane Ingalls, but this isn't the first time she's played a nun. She was in both Sister Act and Sister Act 2 back in The Habit. Man, I wish I was too. It looks so much fun being at a convent.
Number 69. Taryn Manning plays the terrifyingly toothy Pensatucky. I know, I didn't know she looked like that in real life either. As part of her research for the role, she researched evangelist ceremonies and the concept of faith healing, which must have been a fun afternoon.
Number 70. Ironically, in 2012, Manning was arrested days before being cast. She was arrested for assaulting her personal assistant, but took a plea bargain of one day of community service.
Number 71. You may recognise Manning from the 2002 movie Crossroads with Britney Spears. I certainly do. Number 72. The Orange is the New Black cast are certainly a musical bunch. For instance, Annie Golden, who plays Always Quiet's Norma Romano, used to be the lead singer for a punk band called The Shirts in the 70s. Number 73. Also, Leah Delaria, who plays Big Boo, no Clive, geez, not that one, is a jazz musician and a comedian in real life. Number 74. Jessica Pimentel, the actress who shares the same face as Maria Ruiz, planned on being a concert violinist. However, at age 14, she suffered nerve damage and lost the feeling in her fingertips. Number 75. Before they were acting on Orange is the New Black, Uzo Aduba and Leah Delaria performed on Broadway together in 2011 in Prometheus Bound. That's Prometheus Bound, by the way, nothing to do with that frankly awful film of the same name.
Number 76. Natasha Lyonne underwent heart surgery because of a bacterial infection in real life, which is the same surgery that her character Nikki underwent in the show. So the scar you see in the show is actually real.
Number 77. Contradictory to her character, Danielle Brooks has not read any books in the Harry Potter series, which is actually an offence punishable by death here in the UK. She's watched only a few of the movies after she found out her character, Tasty, was a huge fan. So when she makes Harry Potter references, she probably doesn't know what the heck she's talking about.
Number 78. Lorraine Toussaint had no idea that her character V was going to be so evil until her first day on set, when Cohen told her that V was a complete sociopath. Wow, I thought it'd be relatively easy to tell from, you know, the script or something, but hey, what do I know? I'm not an actress. Number 79. An example of this evil, V's attack on Red, was one of the most difficult scenes to film in the whole series. Kate Mulgrew had to be harnessed to the camera so that Toussaint could also be in the shot and get very close to her face without actually hurting anybody. Number 80. Actress Elizabeth Rodriguez, who plays Elaida, Daya's mother, is only a year older than Dasha Polanco, who plays Daya. That means she must have been pregnant when she was... ew. Number 81. Speaking of mothers, Kate Mulgrew and Taylor Schilling acted together before on the TV series Mercy as Mama and, daughter. Number 82. 18 of the actors on Orange is the New Black have appeared in the show Law & Order. Quite fittingly, really, given that it's about prison and that's about crime. Nice. This list of characters includes Pornstache, Pensatucky, Nikki, Red, Poussée, Big Boo, Miss Rosa, Caputa, Sophia, Fig, Brooke, Soso, Gloria Mendoza, Yoga Jones, Cal Chapman, Scott O'Neill, Jenna, Alida Diaz, Norma, and Miss Claudette. Number 83. There's only one character and one character alone who appears in every single episode of Orange is the New Black, and their name is... oh no, wait, sorry. No character appears in every episode.
Number 84. The title name of each episode is said at least once in each respective episode. My personal favourite is Toast Can Never Be Bread Again, because oh my god, it's true. It can't.
Number 85. In the pilot episode, Jason Biggs's character Larry Bloom, oh my god, that's what we're called, complains to Piper that he tells her everything, including the webcam horror and the penis shaving incident, both of which are references to his character Jim in the 1999 comedy American Pie.
Number 86. The real Larry is a talented writer who did write about his relationship with Piper while she was in prison, giving his perspective on the experiences and the whole situation. Number 87. In the episode Bora Bora Bora, where Larry meets Piper for the first time, he is watching television. The show he is watching is Weeds, which was also created by Jenji Cohen. Nice cross-promotion.
Number 88.
The joke starting with, so a penguin and a farmer walk into a bar and ending in the punchline, he's not an eggplant, he's retarded, is delivered by three different characters in three different episodes. Red in Tit Punch, drug dealer Caesar in The Chickening, and Nikki in Can't Fix Crazy. Wow, I'd love to know the feeling of that joke.
Number 89. Even though Larry hasn't been on the show since season 2, and it appears his and Piper's relationship is out of the picture, the real Larry Smith and Piper Kerman are married with a 5-year-old son and living in Ohio right bloody now.
Number 90. Every time Piper is on the phone, there is always another woman on the phone crying. The reason why has never been revealed, but it's probably to do with the fact that she's in prison.
Thanks, guys. Number 91. During the party scene, when Piper heads back to her cell, the camera gives viewers a look at her books. The book on top is The Depths of Despair, written by James Bollenbar. The actual author is Matt Forbeck. James Bollenbar is a producer on the show.
Number 92.
Danielle Brooks, Tasty's actress, stated she did not meet Tika Duplessis, who plays Little Tasty, until after she shot all her scenes. The resemblance between them is uncanny, it's insane. It looks like cloning.
Number 93. The hooch drink, created on the show, is made of just water with some food colouring, fruit cocktail, and something to make it sweet, just in case you want to make it at home for your next party. Actress Samira Wiley, who plays Poussée, is diabetic, so when she chugged the drink for the show, she was only chugging coloured water. Scrummy.
Number 94. In a little bit of life imitating art, during her time working on Orange is the New Black, writer Laura Morelli divorced her husband and is now in a relationship with actress Samira Wiley. That means Orange is the New Black.
Number 95. Actress and potential meal for Anthony Hopkins, Jodie Foster, has directed 2 episodes of Orange is the New Black. She directed the episodes Lesbian Request Denied and Thirsty Bird, both of which are the name of online films that I've watched. Number 96. Actor Andrew McCarthy, best known for St. Elmo's Fire, has also directed 11 episodes of Orange is the New Black. Number 97. In one of the episodes he directed, specifically Low Self-Esteem City in season 2, he makes a cameo appearance as a cardboard figure behind a cop. I mean, that's possibly the laziest cameo in history. He didn't even have to do anything. It's not even him. It's just a replica of him. Why am I so angry? Number 98. Orange is the New Black was one of the first well-known series to be bingeable, and the cast and crew like it that way too. It apparently makes it easier for Cohen because she does not have to worry about writing each character into every single episode. Number 99. Orange is the New Black season 5 is out very soon for us in our own little bubble of time recording this. But 2 months before its June release in April 2017, cybercriminals hacked into a post-production company and stole the season 5 episodes. Wow, when they're caught, they're the ones that are going to be wearing orange. i.e. in prison, I mean, not just, you know, a wardrobe change.
Number 100. The cybercriminal, known as the Dark Overlord, held the episodes to ransom, demanding money in exchange for not leaking the episodes. Netflix didn't pay, and well, guess what? Episodes 2 to 10 of season 5 were leaked online.
Number 101. The Dark Overlord has since said that Netflix may as well release the rest of the season, and states that there are other things on the Netflix menu to feast upon and leak. Uh-oh. I'd edit using tape for a while if I were you, Netflix. I know I sure do. Anyway, onboard time, baby. Come on, Libby and Brogan, let's go.
That was 101 Facts About Orange is the New Black, and I don't know about you or these guys, but I had a great time.
I absolutely loved it, Sam.
Yeah, it was the best thing I've ever seen.
Oh, great. Thanks for helping me out.
Don't you forget to subscribe to Bloom, the best channel on YouTube, bar 101 Facts, of course.
Thank you very much. Yeah, please do subscribe. It will do us all a favour and get these two lovely ladies to the height of internet stardom. You'll be there on the ground floor. Subscribe to Bloom, subscribe to 101 if you can as well, and watch a few videos that are on screen now. Thank you very much. Goodbye.